There is quite the controversy as to what witchcraft really is. Many believe a witch is someone who has made a pact with the devil in exchange for special powers, or that witches are just crazy people who believe in magic, or that it is all just a superstition, and this may be partly true for some. The definition of witch varies drastically across people and cultures. If you're a realist like I am, you need hard evidence and logical answers before you believe in anything, and today I'm going to break it down to you. Just a quick disclaimer, I'm not denying anyone's beliefs, but just expressing mine from my point of view. I am not an expert, I have not studied anything, and this is just what I believe based on my experiences. To me, witchcraft is the use of psychology and natural forces combined. I feel like the ideas of magic, gods, and witchcraft stemmed from the human instinct of needing an answer for everything. Before medicine was science, it was witchcraft. Before volcanoes were science, it was punishment from the gods. Anything we couldn't explain, God and witchcraft were blamed for. These days, however, I believe witchcraft has a new purpose. It is the power of psychology and natural forces being used alongside science to better our lives. I don't believe witchcraft can be used to win the lottery, or to make someone fall in love with you, or to heal a horribly ill person. I believe it can be used as a means of focus, to set goals and intentions and assist in working towards these goals. Every action has consequences. In witchcraft, we act in order to achieve certain consequences. We put our intention out into the universe in order for it to come back and manifest within our lives. Witchcraft is used to better the way we experience life and improve ourselves as people. It is a faith that promises something bigger and better than what we have. The mind is so powerful that if you are 100% convinced you are allergic to something and you consumed that thing, your skin would literally break out into a rash. It's something called the placebo effect. So powerful that even doctors were prescribing their patients with placebo or empty pills, however the patients didn't know that they were empty and actually saw improvements in their condition. This is why belief is so important. Your brain is always tricking itself and your body through belief. If you performed a spell for a job interview and you believed it worked, you would go into that job interview with much more confidence and thus you are more likely to nail it, therefore achieving your manifestation. The biggest thing in the way of our ability to succeed as humans is doubt and insecurity, and with belief you can achieve confidence, happiness, and peace. Furthermore, if you performed an anxiety spell, for example, not only would you have the same psychological influence, but if you were to carry around a spell sachet full of lavender, the aroma will literally take you off edge. It's proven science, it's medicine, but of course, should never be replaced with professional medical care. Witchcraft, however, is a form of medical science through the use of natural herbs, and it's been done for centuries. There was a point in ancient time where there were no doctors, just witches. If you healed people, you were a witch. Another topic I want to discuss is the use of crystals. While there isn't too much scientific evidence on the use of crystals, I still believe being in contact with certain crystals affects your mind and body in different ways, through our reaction to color and beauty, and mostly just belief. For example, when you see a nice chocolate dessert, and your body starts releasing dopamine. But if you think about it, chocolate is just another substance, but we psychologically pair joy with it. Or when you were a kid and had a toy that you needed to carry around with you to feel safe and happy. As a kid, I literally had rocks, and I was attached to them. And opposingly, if you get blackout drunk drinking Jack Daniels, even hearing the name Jack Daniels will make you feel sick. Like when we walk into a dim room with red bedsheets and candles and roses, we physically feel romantic. It is just programmed in our mind to pair these things with romance, and therefore it effectively sets the mood, manifesting our intention. It's psychology. Your brain is literally releasing chemicals as a reaction to belief. Similarly, crystals can be programmed using your mind and setting intent. If you believe certain crystals will do certain things, then they will. With reason, of course. When I pick up certain crystals, I get this tingle through my body. I feel happy and calm, and this feeling varies across types of crystals, so I do believe there is something about them that hasn't been explained yet. Another thing I find interesting is that you often see babies with amber necklaces. This is because the frequencies of the amber cause them to warm up, which when in contact with the baby's skin makes the baby release oils, which leads to a reduction in swelling of the gums of teething babies. That's science. Divination is a common practice throughout witchcraft as a means of diving into your subconscious. There is so much information in your subconscious mind that you just don't have access to. For example, some information you read months ago when it was irrelevant, and now you need it. It's stored somewhere way back in your memory, and divination is a method in retrieving this information. Pendulum dowsing, for example. In my opinion, this isn't actually a spirit answering your questions, it's your subconscious mind. The energy from inside your body transfers through your arm into the pendulum and out into an answer. Although tarot cards are technically a means of divination, I don't believe it works the same way. Tarot cards basically tell the future, but it's not really magic. Again, it's a way to narrow down your focus points. For example, if a tarot card tells you something good is going to happen soon, good things are always happening, but if your tarot card didn't remind you of this, then you may have overlooked it, and this thing would pass you by, and you wouldn't have been prepared to stop and appreciate it. Life can be so overwhelming, as we are all so busy, and tarot cards just tell you to stop and focus on this one thing, and sometimes we just need that. At this point in time, I haven't quite worked my head around the belief of gods, but I have grasped some kind of concept of spirits. I personally don't believe in active spirits. I believe a spirit is a kind of vibe emitted by a person, and in their spirit includes everything they express and convey, what they taught you, and basically their sense of being, belonging, believing, and benevolence. We study the spirits of those who pass to figure out these things about them through divination, which is really just a means of reaching into our subconscious. We are taking what we already know about them to figure out what they were trying to teach us, to gain knowledge and insight. Another reason we may want to contact spirits is to reconnect with loved ones and people we miss, and unfortunately, as of now, I believe we can only reconnect with our memories of them. I am definitely not rejecting the possibility of witchcraft and magic beyond my beliefs. I, as a realist, however, am only able to accept the things that make sense to me through logic and experience. I'm learning more and more about my craft every day, and I'm always open to new discoveries. Being able to have beliefs based on science, fact, and experience, however, make my beliefs and my craft so much stronger. So I think that's everything that's on my mind for now. I hope it makes sense. I'm not sure if I'm just rambling on about nonsense. I don't know. And I'm always open to hear new ideas and opinions, so please feel free to share yours. I hope you enjoyed this video and enjoyed what I had to say, and thanks for listening and watching.